Hello, everyone, and welcome to another quarterly update on the Darlington Nuclear Refurbishment Project. I'm here at Pickering's Training and Mock-up Building, not a place where you would expect me to be, giving an update on the Darlington Refurbishment. Yet this is where some of the reactor components for Unit 2 are being put together. More on this in a moment. Let's first talk about the project's overall performance. We recently passed the two-year mark on the Darlington Unit 2 refurbishment. Since then, we've taken the reactor apart and are now well along the road of rebuilding Unit 2 and restoring it for 30 more years of clean, safe, and reliable operation. We have now surpassed over 11 million hours worked with zero lost time injuries. Thank you to the thousands of dedicated workers making Canada's largest clean energy project also the safest project in Canada. We have now completed 70% of the work on Unit 2 and the project remains on schedule. The big news is our success with bulk work. This includes balance of plant projects like our turbine and generator overhaul, as well as reactor safety systems, which are all now complete. This work also involved the cleaning of our boilers, where over 10,000 pounds of magnetite was removed. The boilers are in excellent condition and will safely run for decades to come. We have now installed all 480 calandria tubes and sealed them into the reactor with 960 insert rings. This is the first step to making the reactor whole again. With the calandria tube installation behind us, we've now moved on to fuel channel assemblies. And here, at Pickering, in the training and mock-up building, is where that all begins. With me today is Jared Gagnon, construction manager for OPG.
So the purpose of the clean room is to provide a clean, secure, safe location for the production of fuel channel assemblies. This includes environmental controls to align with station requirements.
So what's involved in assembling a fuel channel?
So the production of a fuel channel subassembly starts with the allocation of the components being directly serialized to a specific location in the reactor. Once those components are identified, pressure tubes are cut to length, and then they are inserted into an end fitting. Once this evolution is completed, we then perform the roll joint. Once the roll joint is complete, we do leak testing on the joint. Now, throughout all this process, there are many quality witness points and hold points within our inspection and test plans.
As you can see, a lot of quality work by OPG, Canadam, and all of our vendors is underway, delivering on our commitment to safely bring Unit 2 back to service on time, on budget, and with quality. It's an exciting time. We're now on the road to restart. Everyone is fully engaged and looking ahead to support the safe and timely return to service of Unit 2 to full power operation.